John, I think that's probably one of the worst results Berwick Rangers have had for many a season. And, you know, I don't really know what to say about the game, to be honest with you. It was, I can't say they were the better team, but I think the goals we conceded and, you know, the way we went about the game, the players, it didn't seem like a cup tie to me, to be honest with you.
No, I was saying to the people during the first half that were standing around me, if you were outside the ground, you wouldn't know there was a game on today. You know, this is a professional team who get paid to do a job, playing against a lower league team who they should beat 10 times out of 10. No, 9 times out of 10 they should beat them. But it's indicative of the way we've went about things this season. When we are the underdog in games, we counter-attack well, we defend our goal well today. When, again, when we've had to make the running, which has happened on two or three occasions. Think back to Elgin, I think back to Edinburgh City even when we went there. Spartans, we were supposedly the better side, you know, technically when we found out. We were poor in the ball, we were slow in the ball. We allowed them to go ahead with just a ridiculous comic cut goal that should never have been conceded. And from then on in, you know, Josh Morris comes back to haunt us and did what my highly paid strikers should be doing, you know, which is running towards the opposition goal and actually trying to score goals instead of running offside continuously. We were poorly doing it in the department, but at the end of the day, you know, the players have had a bad day. It's been a bad day for the club in general, and there's no getting away from that. There's no escaping it. You know, that comes down to me. You know, I picked the team, I brought these players here. Nobody put them under pressure to put them on the park, so the buck will stop with myself, and that's the way it should be. You know, as a manager, you've got to live with the highs and you've got to live with the lows, and this is certainly one of my CV that I don't know what to be remembered for. You know, I said to the players at half time, you know, I came here. I've got good memories of winning the league here as a manager, but the last thing I'll be remembered for is losing against Hawke. You know, and that's something that I'd hoped that we'd have got a reaction in the second half to. We got a goal, we missed some unbelievable chances that, you know, we should have scored.
But we had ourselves in a situation during half time.
Yeah.
Where I'm sitting here saying if we get a draw in this game, it'll be a good result for us. And really, I mean, I was saying to people before the game, what I was wanting to see today is us come against them, because no disrespect to them, but they are a much lesser team, or they should be a much lesser team than us, that we might get four or five goals to do. That's the way I was looking at the game pre-match, you know?
Yeah. I've not seen any of the players that every other manager in the country has said, this is their cup final, they'll be up for the game, you've got to make sure you do this, you've got to do that. I mean, you know, it's not as if we don't talk to the players. We're telling them, trying to prepare the players the best we can for the situation. We know that they're going to come with a bit of spirit, they've got absolutely nothing to lose. What you can't then do is give them encouragement and actually help them along the way, and we did. I mean, it was. I'm not going to use the word embarrassing. You know,
the goals were conceded, John. Were just unbelievable goals.
Yeah.
You know,
we've not lost a game away from home this season. We've got one of the best defensive records, if not the best in the league. And we come on and put a performance like that, and you wonder what the situation is and why that happens. You know, and I'm the same as everybody else. I'm watching it. There's very little I can do once the game starts. I made a change before half time. I couldn't watch it any longer, but I thought it was the last thing I'd do at the club. I may as well do something positive and try and make a change and get the boy Rutherford on the park, which, you know, was obviously a bonus to us, and it looks as if he'll be a good player for the club.
The boy's still in that right back. Was that just a position you wanted?
No, we played three centre-halves. We played 3-5-2. Ben came in there. Ben's normally very cultured in the ball. We knew we'd have possession of the ball today, and we thought that we would get out that side. He's played the last couple of games for Hibs in the development team as a right centre-half, so he goes in there. It was under him and Lee Hamilton, who's no kicked the ball for about 6 weeks. So, you know, suspensions have deprived us of our captain as a centre-half, and Ken McKinley, you know, again, it's another external force that we've had to deal with today. You know, the chopping and changing of the team. Ben comes in. I felt, you know, at half-time I had to get Hamilton's power going up the side of the park and try and do something about it.
But at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who was on the pitch for us today. I think we were good enough, I should have been good enough to take this team and go on to the next one.
Yeah.
My thoughts on the whole game, John,
I've been doing this 20-odd years and I've heard that said many dressing rooms and I've heard many conversations, and I've been part of the conversations where we should have done this and we should have done that, and we've ended up with egg in our face. You know, you've got to take it in the chin, and the club certainly has to move on, you know, that's the way it is. I mean, I've said before, I'll take responsibility for the thing. I pick the players, nobody tells me how to pick a team, you know, so I put them on the part. Tactically, it's my job to get them up for the game. That looked like it didn't happen today. The response in the second half, as I say, we made lots of chances, wasn't enough. You know, I didn't see enough fire about us. You know, even at half, you know, second half, you wouldn't know there was a game on sometimes.
That's why I say it wasn't like the Cup, the Scottish Cup game. I mean, the Scottish Cup, you're always fired up for the Cup game, and you know, it was the game you could release yourself because it's not a league game.
Yes.
And anyhow, I don't want to dwell on things, but anyhow, I do appreciate you coming to talk to us.
No problem. You know, I mean, I had two performers in the park. I thought Stevie Thompson and Stevie Notman, and you would expect Stevie Notman to give his all else. Does, you know, he's in there, he's sharp. Stevie Thompson was the driving force of Miller Park. After that, I'm looking around the park and thinking, because anybody care, you know. So there was a lot of energy in the dugout. There wasn't a lot of energy
on the pitch.
That's right. So, you know, you take the consequences as a manager, and I say we've taken plenty of pats on the back of my time here. So now you take the consequences when a bad result comes along. So that's it. So I'll speak to the powers that be and then see where we go from here.
Right. Well, obviously a lot of Bayern Rangers support is very disappointed. Yeah. So, but thanks very much, John.
Okay.
Thanks very much indeed.
No problem. Thanks, Eric. Thanks. Cheers. Thanks. Cheers.